Good morning, dear students. I'm Tony Jose, your moral science teacher, and we are going to study the moral science. The first chapter is the influence of friends. So we all have friends, and we know that we are dealing with our friends. Once a great man said that, if you tell me who is your friend, I will tell you who you are. So it simply shows that what influence a friend is making on our life. So it says that if you say that who is your friend, we can understand that who you are. Or another, there is a saying that the birds of same feather flows together. So it means that people, those who are of a similar category, makes friends. So you know, see, like, if when you are having a friend, you can also understand that, see, like, many of the time that your friends will be there almost of your own categories or your own interest. So you have the friends have always a influence in our life. Okay, so sometimes some friends are there which help us to lead us a good life, and some friends may be taking us to bad life, or they will be taking us in a wrong path. So we have to understand who are our friends and what influence they are having on us. And the age, like your teenager, now you are in a teenage, and this is the time that you have more influence of friends. So that is why we are studying about this particular chapter, and in this we study that what influence the friends are having in our life, and whether it is good or whether it is beneficial or not, or this type of things we are going to study. Peer pressure refers to the influence that your friends have on you. So the peer pressure, so the meaning of peer pressure means that the influence of your friends. So peer means the companions, and the pressure, peer pressure means that, see, like, if you find that another person is doing something, you also feel like to do that. So that is called as the peer pressure. Okay, or your friends are there, so if you are in a friends group and all of them are doing something, so you will be also forced to do those things. So it may be a good things or a bad things, whatever may be there, but there is a tendency that they will also force us. It means that, doesn't mean that they are forcing us, but it simply shows that we get a chance of or we feel like to follow them or just do the same way what they are doing. It causes you to change your attitude, values and behavior so as to remain in tune with your friends. So the peer pressure will be motivating us or forcing us to change our attitude. So we have a particular attitude towards different things. So but when we are in a group of, or when we are having a friends, then the attitude of the group towards that particular things will be the same like ours also. So our attitude may be changed. And our values, so we from our family atmosphere and all, we learn a lot amount of values. And these values may be getting changed. You might have seen some students up to 10th class, they are studying in our school, and their behavior and their things and all will be very much good. But when they go out of the place, and when they are staying in hostel, and they go to Kanpur, Lucknow and so on, and they study there, and they have their entire character may be getting changed. So it is because of the peer pressure. Okay, because their values, whatever the values that they have changed, whatever they had maintained, that might be changing because of their friends. And the behavior also, so the way that they are behaving, that may be also changing. So this, and we try to become similar to our friends. So how our friends are there, so sometimes it may be improving, sometimes it may be going worse. Okay, most of the time it is going worse, that is the problem. And but sometimes it may help us to improve our talents and improve our behaviors and so on. It also causes you to change your response towards the world around you. It is a pressure that affects individuals of all ethnicities, genders and ages. So it is the matter for everyone. It is not that only few particular people are there. Ethnicities means that the different cultural backgrounds. So which culture you are following. Like if you are people from UP or people from Bihar or wherever may be the place, or whatever may be the culture, whatever may be the background that we are having. Or it does not mean about different age groups, as well as it does not mean about any particular gender. Every people are affecting these things. Peer pressure and adolescence. Let us now discuss what are the connection between this. Adolescence refers to your teen age. What is the meaning of teenage? You know, So like from 13 onwards, so most of you are in the age of 14 or 13. So this is the time of your teenage. So teenage means that the 13 to 19, though this age is there. So ending with teen, all these years, all these numbers are there, or the ages are there, that is ending with teen. And this is the time that you see until 12 years of age, or until before the teenage, you are considered as a child. And when you come into this teenage, then you start growing as a boy or a girl, and your physical changes are there, and your body is getting ready or becoming like as an adult. Okay, so by the time of 19, you will become a fully adult, and see like your all the characteristics or features will be changing. So these changes will be taking place. Some of the voices are there, moustache is coming out, beard is coming out. So all these type of things are there. For girls also, there are so many changes that are taking place. So these changes will be there in the teenage. Okay, and this is a very important or a very crucial time in the life of a people. So, and at that time, see, like what happens is that till the age when we are very small, when we are babies, we depend on our parents. First, whatever may be the problem that we find, we ask to our parents. Okay, so if you have any kind of issues, any kind of problems, anything, whatever is there, that we discuss with our parents. But what happens to the teenage is that you don't feel that much freedom you don't get from your parents. So sometimes some people, they get that freedom, or some parents are entertaining the children to ask, help them to ask a few questions, and they clear the questions. So, but most of the time what happens is that they ask these doubts. So they have a lot amount of doubts, and most of the time they ask these doubts to the friends. And the friends are also there, so they also are in the same position. But when somebody is asking us something, then they pretend to be that they know everything, and they sometimes give wrong answers. So such a way it may go to a wrong situations. So there is a connection like that. It is the traditional period of physical and psychological development between childhood and maturity. So this is the period where you grow from child to a mature boy or a girl. During adolescence, the body and mind go through many complex changes, some of which are difficult to deal with. So this time, in this period, there is a lot amount of changes are taking place in our body physically as well as in our mind. So when our body is changing, like if your moustache is coming, then we think that I am a boy, I have grown up. So this type of feeling will be there. So your mind also is changing, your attitude towards different things will be changing, and as well as the physical appearance also will be changing. For girls also, they are start growing, their size will be increasing, and they start growing long hairs, and their body parts and all are changing. So such a way they feel that I am something different. So some feel little awkward and all, and some feel it is that as good. So there are some so many changes are there. So whatever the changes like taking place, we cannot exactly define, or there are some changes we cannot understand also. So it is very difficult to deal with this thing. Peer pressure is the hallmark of adolescence, because it is the period that a person is most susceptible to peer pressure. When children enter this period for the first time, they actually become aware about the people around them and realize the importance of perception in their interactions. So in this is a very crucial period, and in this time we start observing others, especially our friends, what our friends are doing. So what hairstyle my friend is keeping, and I want to keep that. What type of dress my friend is wearing, I want to use that. So this is the attitude of the people. So they start observing what others are doing and try to do that way. Peer conformity in young people is most pronounced with respect to style, taste, appearance, ideology and values. So all these type of things, like your taste, your style, your appearance, ideology and values. So all these type of things you try to copy from your friends. Peer pressure is commonly associated with adolescence. Risk taking, as children tend to indulge in risky activities because of the influence of their friends. So this is another problem is that, see, like people, those who are in this, if you, they observe others and they tend to do some kind of risky activities, like some are trying to do like cycling or bike riding or learning all these type of things are there, and after that you try to go for a long ride or with along with your companions, maybe in a cycle or a bike or such kind of things are there. So you want to do some picnics or so some type of dangerous things you may be interested to do. So many kind of things, like you may interested to have like food outside. You will gather together outside some tea shop and all. So nowadays, like because of the corona, even now people are just roaming around like that. So in this age, people, they want to mingle with others and they want to be together with your friends. Okay, girls and boys both face differing amounts of pressure in different areas of their lives, perhaps reflecting a different set of values and priorities. So it is not different for boys and girls. Both girls and boys are having the same type of problems are there. So, but the problems that they are facing or the things that they are dealing with may be different, but they all have this peer pressure is there. Okay, see, like mostly like girls and all are there, they are wearing dresses, the ornaments that they are wearing or the dresses that they are wearing. So they see that other one of your friend is wearing a particular dress and you also want to copy that or you want to purchase that, and you start fighting with your parents for purchasing such kind of things. So such kind of behaviors and all will be there. Or maybe like a hairstyle, when you are using any hair clips, maybe there or there, such kind of things are there. So you will find that somebody is using that and you ask them that from where did you purchase this one, and you will go and purchase and you ask your parents to purchase and give these things. So such kind of things will be there. However, girls have significantly higher pressures to conform to their group in the form of the choice of dress or speech styles. But more comparing with the boys, the girls have more influenced by the peer pressure. So they want to be always mingling with others and they want to do what all others are doing. Boys are there, they are also affected, but they don't care much. And even in this age, they don't care much about what others are doing. So they see like more depending on themselves. But the girls are there, they try to be more competent with the companions, and you try to get it from what the others are doing, the same way you want to copy it. In adolescence, peer pressure can be positive as well as negative. However, the importance of peer pressure, peers and their influence somewhat decline on entering adulthood. So see, like the importance of this one, so there can be a positive impact as well as a negative impact. So the peer pressure can be a positive or a negative. But as you enter, maybe like when you reach the age of 19 or when you reach around 20, so by the time your influence on your friends will be changing. See, like at the time the marriage age and all is coming, and people will be start thinking of a marriage and all. So at that time, their this peer pressure will be changing. So in this age, like especially like schooling, colleges this time, so you are having more connection with your friends. After that, when you become like after completing your teenage, you may be busy with a job, so you will be settled in a particular place. And you can, after you person may get married, and after that they come into their family. So their connection with their friends will be lost. So that is why they don't have much impact on the this peer pressure may not be there. But this age is there from almost like from 10 year to 10 to 20 years, we can say, even though it is a teenage, but 10 to 20 years, we can say this period is there. So there so much amount of influence of friends are there. So we also are affected by this, and we have to face these things, and we have to understand what is positive. So you should there is nothing wrong in copying with others or you influencing of the friends is there, but you should see to it that what you are doing is good or not. So just by looking at other person, don't simply copy anything. If it is good one, you can copy, but if it is not good, then don't copy. Okay, so that you have to keep in mind. Okay, that's all about the chapter. So half of that is over. Remaining portion we study in the next class. Thank you so much.